Hi, I'm Joshua Stevens from the South Metro Atlanta campus, and today we will be looking at Luke 20, verses 9 through 18. It begins with verse 9, but he began to tell the people this parable. A man planted a vineyard and leased it to the vine growers, and went on a journey for a long time, and at the harvest time, he sent a slave to the vine growers so that they would give him his share of the produce of the vineyard. But the vine growers beat him and sent him away empty-handed. Verse 11, and he proceeded to send another slave, but they beat him also and treated him shamefully and sent him away empty-handed. And he proceeded to send a third, but this one too they threw out. Verse 13, now the owner of the vineyard said, what am I to do? I will send my beloved son. Perhaps they will respect him. But when the vine growers saw him, they discussed with one another, saying, this is the heir. Let's kill him so that the inheritance will be ours. Verse 15, and so they threw him out of the vineyard and killed him. What then will the owner of the vineyard do to them? He will come and put these vine growers to death and will give the vineyard to others. However, when they heard this, they said, may it never happen. All right, so one thing that I have learned is that we are the vine growers. In this parable, Jesus teaches and shows these people the outcome of killing the heir to the vineyard and taking the inheritance for themselves. Verse 16 clearly states that he will come and put these vine growers to death and will give the vineyard to others. These people pleaded for it not to happen, but it did. Let it be known that the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is the eternal life through Jesus Christ, our Lord. So personally, I need to remember that this life is not my own. God is leasing us to this world for his glory, and one day we will return to him. The vine growers thought that this world was their inheritance, but we as Christians know that the true inheritance is the kingdom of God. So Lord, I just want to thank you for this time just to be with the rest of the body of Go Church. Just to be here in these 21 days of prayer and fasting, Lord, let us remain steadfast in what we are doing, what we are asking you for in this time of prayer and fasting, Lord. And let us just remember that this world is not our own. And yet we are still sinners, Lord, that through Christ Jesus, we will enter the kingdom of God. In Jesus' name, amen.